Social distancing is simply behavior. It's a series of behaviors. They're very specific behaviors. I think that we are in such a state of fear at times that we think it's this really complex medical thing. The behaviors that are defined of social distancing are very lawful, what controls them, and systematic, and is what we're going to talk about a little today. The point of this quote here by B.F. Skinner I wanted to start off with is that the ideal situation of behaviorism is to eliminate coercion and to change the environment in a way that reinforces the kind of behavior that benefits everyone. Six little OBM principles that can be used, and these guys are doing it for real downstairs, and they're doing it at scale one by one. And there are a minority of clinicians going into homes using these same strategies, but a little bit differently than what I had proposed here. I just threw out a couple ideas. Like, the first thing in performance management and OBM is just having a checklist, a guide, which is an antecedent. Secondly, goal setting. Goal setting is simply an antecedent. So the goal setting, specifying the reinforcement earned in a collective group. So I'm thinking at scale, not just the clinic, not just in the home, but when malls begin to open up. We need to figure out how can we use the science in a broader scope to be able to save lives. And that's real simple. The goal setting is something that's important by, after people review the checklist of particular items they need to engage in, the reminder of the PPE, the reminder of the 6 feet, the reminder of all the rules, it's kind of a pre-correction type of strategy, then going into the setting with setting a collective group goal. So, we haven't done this yet, but this is just a suggestion that we're looking at. When we start getting in groups again, one by one, as states open up, my suggestion is that we use behavioral science to set goals. And there's a collective goal for a group of people in a group setting. It's very clear and it's visual. Third step, an idea could be momentary time sampling. So basically, just if you could just picture an iPhone or an Android in your pocket that buzzes on certain intervals, if you're the supervisor of that clinic or that area or that classroom, it goes off on certain intervals, 30 seconds, 1 minute, 2 minute, and the person looks up when it goes off and they quickly take data on an iPad. At that glance, when they look across, how many people are wearing PPE, are social distancing, engaging in all the right behaviors, and reinforcing it instead of just using forced coercion and what we're seeing by certain governments, which is horrible. What we could do in these larger groups is consider if the goal is met that was set collectively for the classroom, for the people in the mall, for a small area like this, we can use positive reinforcement to reinforce the entire group and based on whatever the goal was. So if you just picture visually, we're shooting for 90% compliance for all the intervals. There's 10 intervals during the observation. If 9 out of 10 of those intervals, the supervisor looked up or the clinician checked off that they were all following it at each glance on those intervals, and you have 90%. The whole team that was in a clinic wins. It's positive, people feel inspired as opposed to what we see earlier. And it freaking saves lives. So you can also look at the magnitude of the reinforcer. So maybe if they fall short of 90%, there's a smaller reward for 80%, 70%. Hit the like button, please, and then hit the bell, because the bell will notify you when new videos come out.